Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Well, the tutorials out there, they didn't explain Feature Builder and Stream Builder. They didn't explain it clearly, what are they and when to use. I'm gonna do it for you. First, Feature Builder. You use Feature Builder to do a job only once, to get a job done only once. For example, you wanna make a network request, you wanna get data from network, you use Feature Builder because you just make a call to the API once, you wait for the data, get the data, and then you use the data and that's it. Or you just want to call a function only once and that's it. On the other hand, Stream Builder is get called for consistency. For example, continuously from the server, or you want to get connected to the server, or you want to know what is happening on the server and get the response back to your app and show it to the user or tell the user or tell the UI. So whenever you have data that's incoming all the time or changes data all the time, then you should use Stream Builder. Now here I have this simple app. Let's go ahead and take a look. So over here, this is happening through Feature Builder and this is happening through Stream Builder. So what is this? Now for Feature Builder, this is our function. And over here, I'm calling a function inside this Feature Builder and the function name is calculate square. So I give it a number 10 and it returns me 100. So here is my function. And as we do it, we delay 5 and the answer. And this job only gets done only once. This job gets done only once. And after that, there are no changes and I don't need to call it. And that's as simple as that one. And how we are doing it? We are putting it inside Feature Builder. We are calling a function that will get the job done only once and then you are good to go. Now let's take a look at Stream Builder. So this is our Stream Builder. Now over here, just like Feature Builder, we have Stream Builder. And then we are calling a function which is called stopwatch. And what is this doing? So it's returning a value every 1 second later. And that's why instead of using the keyword return, we use the word yield, because with a return function, that returns once and that's done. You don't want to use that function anymore. But because we are using Stream Builder and we want to get continuous output from our function or from the server, so that's why inside this stopwatch function, as we return, we have to return yield. And it gets automatically called after every 1 second later, and it returns the value after every 1 second later. And that's what's happening over here. As you can see, every 1 second later, the value is changing. Okay, so once again, if you have continuous change of data, you should use Stream Builder. If your data you want to get only once, you use Feature Builder. Now we'll take a look at another example. So look at this app. In this app, I'm using Google to sign into Firebase or a custom sign in method, but regardless, whatever it is, over here, I have used, inside this material app, over here, I have used Stream Builder. Why? Because I wanna get connected to the server because I may log in anytime, I may log out anytime. That's why the Firebase server and app, they should get connected. They should know if there are any changes, whether the user has logged in or not. And it should happen through Stream Builder. So it's a very powerful widget. Every time you wanna get connected to the server and get new information continuously, you should go ahead and do it inside Stream Builder.